tonight we are sharing the legacy of Ann Uccello, the state's first female mayor and the first female mayor of a capital city in the entire country. The trailblazer passed away today at the age of 100. Channel 3's Sam Smink spoke with the people who knew her best. She joins us in Hartford at the very street named after the pioneer.
Not many people get a street named after them, but Ann Uccello was not an ordinary person.
The exceptional Miss Uccello, and she was. There is no other way to say it. All I have to say about Ann and myself, it was just very special. We will miss her dearly, my wife and I.
Holding a hand-drawn photo of Ann that Uccello herself gave to him, Paul Pigiotto remembers their 10-year friendship and his decision to write a book on the trailblazer.
It really was, you know, a joy that I would have never expected to experience in life.
In a city run by Democrats, Uccello was not only a Republican running for mayor in 1967, but a female. She won twice. She then went on to work in the Nixon, Ford, and Carter administrations.
That means a lot that it was a woman, of course, in the 60s that did it on her own. This was a challenging time, and she took the reins.
Pigiotto says getting to know her story, it was clear she always followed her faith and heart, not politics.
The focus that she had, it's incredible. I read back some of their speeches. She was one of the first ones to talk about lead poisoning.
Uccello was also one of the first to talk about affordable housing in Hartford. Governor Lamont speaking on Uccello's accomplishments, saying she fought to expand housing, ensure that children have access to essential services, and encourage job growth and opportunities in Hartford. With Lieutenant Governor Susan Bisewitz adding, she served with a level of empathy, understanding, and care that is so needed in politics. And current Hartford Mayor Luke Bronin noting, Ann Uccello broke glass ceilings, but beyond that, she led Hartford through an enormously challenging and consequential time with courage, clarity, and compassion.
It wasn't just the fact that she was a female. That was almost secondary to her. She was focused on policy and the right policy, and didn't matter where they came from. That was Ann.
One thing everyone can agree on, her legacy will live on. Reporting in Hartford, Sam Smink, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.